What's up guys, the Bobcat here, and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Now, last time, we played as Eden. Excuse me. And we unfortunately lost horribly. And I'll get more into that, I suppose, when we actually start playing. So we have stuff to talk about. But who do we want to play as? We've got a choice between Judas, Eve, and that's an Eden, but we'll save Eden because I've already played as him and I don't want to play as him again. So, Judas or Eve? I'm going to choose Eve. So, on our last run, what happened? Ooh, what are you? Sad bombs? Huh. They must explode and produce tears. But, as I was saying, on the last run, we played as Eden twice because, oh, I didn't see that damn spike. Off to a great start already, as you can tell. But, again, for the 12th time, on the last run, we were playing as Eden. We got technology right off the bat, which was great, and I threw it on a boss trap room, which has disheartened me greatly. Shouldn't have gone to the boss trap room in the first place, but we live and learn. And then I decided to do another one directly after it in the same video, and we also lost that because we got absolutely nothing. We'll head into the boss room. Larry Jr. Not the worst boss to be going against. Yep, that's what sad bombs do. I think we can afford to just whittle him down now. I mean, our tears aren't great, but I don't know if a bomb is worth it for Larry Jr. I mean, the first one did a pretty substantial amount of damage. Took him down to half. If he'd hit him directly in both parts, then we would have got a lot more out of it. But, yeah, he's nearly dead already. Oh, I walked right into that. One thing I really don't like having, not much damage. Toothpicks. This is a tears plus shot speed up. Heck, I'll take a tears. I do not care about shot speed upgrades. Which is something I never really understood. Because apparently, shot speed upgrades in the first Binding of Isaac, which I never played, or much of, were actually really horrible for some reason. And I never understood why. I mean, they're not great, but I like them. After all, I'd rather have quick tears than slow tears. And I don't care about your argument for lump of coal. Okay, pill. No tinted rocks? Nope. Let's take the pill. Explosive diarrhea. I went through a door so it didn't count. Well, that's one way to discover pills. Now then, we'll shoot the poop. I don't think it has anything in it. In fact, I very much doubt it does. And down to the next floor. So far so good. We've got a decent number of bombs. I hope the tears effect from the bombs actually scales with our overall damage. Ooh, super pride. This is scary. First time I fought super pride. And our tear bomb just wrecked him. Ooh, oh, hoping we could dodge that. Hey, dead cat. Ooh. We'll come back to it. I can't trust myself to, take it into, oh, whatever, we'll do it. Should we? I want to take it, but I can't help but feel that I will die, because I'm terrible at surviving with only one heart. And I know this from the fact that I recorded a Judas run, excuse me, directly after the Eden one, and died on the first floor of flies. More specifically, the Duke of Flies. So, I do not feel comfortable going down to one heart. Ooh, box of spiders? Oh, I guessed that right. And it's an active item. Juice of spiders. Okay. Pretty self-explanatory. What do we have down here? These guys and the poops. I don't know what these guys are called. I really should watch the credits at some point and find out what all the names are. Even if I don't remember them, at least I'll have some vague idea. No tinted rocks. These guys I do not like, but they're not too bad. I mean, they die pretty easily. Three shots, I think. Maybe four for us. Another key. If we get enough money, or if we find the secret room, we could actually visit the shop. Hey, tinted rock. Ooh! Nailed him with the thingy. Can't speak, obviously. I'm going to go back and get dead cat. Because now we have a spirit heart, and I feel a lot more comfortable with the spirit heart. Where could the secret room be is a question. There's four places it could be. We could go into the curse room and neutralise one place, which leaving is only two. Or we could just try. We'll put one here and see what we get. Not there, unfortunately. Oh yeah, also because we took 9 lives, Horror of Babylon activated. In here, Monstro. Nice and easy. Monstro is a simple boss to fight. Also, he seems to appear on the second floor quite a lot. I watch Banning Rise of Rebirth on Northern Lions, but he seems to always fight Monstro, and he keeps saying this is some sort of conspiracy. What do we get? The screw, which I think is an evil upgrade. Notice the tears plus shot speed. Well, I'm happy about the tears. And in here we have 3 red chests. Well, we'll see what we get. Spiders! And not the friendly kind. And wow, we can't kill spiders in one hit. Bombs. And more spiders. No, not worth it. But we didn't lose anything, so... No harm, no foul, I suppose. Do we head to the... curse room? Yes, I want to say, but we'll use a bomb to check if the secret room is next to it. I don't feel comfortable going because we will lose the spirit heart. 2 bombs. Well, it's worth it. We'll blow up some of these as well. See if we can't get some pills. Got a pill? What is it? Health up. I couldn't have asked for anything better. We'll poke our heads into the curse room now. 2 black hearts. Well, that was worth it. A net positive. We also know that there's either a health downgrade pill or a health upgrade pill in our rotation. And I say that because we had 1 health, so if there is a health downgrade, it became a health upgrade, but only for that 1 time. If there's just a health upgrade pill in the rotation, I am more than happy with that. We'll head to the small rooms first. Oh, I just realised we shouldn't have taken a heart, really. Because now we lost the effects of Horror of Babylon, and we haven't got any damage upgrades. We've got tears, which is nice, but no damage. Actually, since we took Dead Cat, there might be a good chance for us becoming Guppy, which would be very nice. Speaking of Guppy, we're on 5 minutes, and we're on the 3rd floor. Ooh, hello, Dry Baby. Dry Baby gives a Necronomicon effect, or a Death Card effect, every couple of rooms. I don't know if it charges with how much damage you take or how it actually works, but I know it does do the Necronomicon effect. Which sounds like a really bad film, the Necronomicon effect. Now then, oh, there it is. And in here we have silkworms. Probably didn't need to use box of spiders since they got neutralized in one hit by that silkworm's tear. Or shot, I suppose. Not really tears, they're spitting them. Another bomb. Getting a nice amount of consumables. Not worth it. We've been to the item room, so we might as well fight Mega Fatty. Probably should have done with getting a... Oh, walked right into him. I was concentrating on the poo. What was I going to say now? Getting the secret room, I think I was going to say? I don't know. And you guys don't either, because it was in my head and then I lost it. I don't really want to use a second bomb. We're wailing on him pretty well. So the easy one to dodge. Move around. Watch out for the jumps, because they are quick. Especially if you're not very far away. And he's dead. Thank you, Dead Bird, as well, for helping out there. And health upgrade. That's fine. Would, again, really like some damage at this point. Our health is in a good situation. Not great, but decent. We're at Isaac and Lazarus starting HP. And there's the secret room. We have 3 bombs. Well, we're getting a positive in terms of bombs from them, which is nice, I suppose. Let's explore the rest of the floor. I don't want to spend too long. Again, getting boss rush would actually be quite nice. Let's blow these up. Hopefully we'll get a pill from them. We did. We got Liberty Cap and Explosive Diarrhea. Not the ideal pill, but it's pretty good. Well, I say pretty good very loosely. It can be good in certain situations. It's almost like a free attempt at clearing a room from with rocks or mushrooms or skulls, depending on how we're feeling. Also, it can be used to get secret rooms, so it's not so bad. Not great, but not terrible. And it can also blow us up in the process, so we have to be very careful. We do not have a good damage. Oh, we'll leave that because I want to go in here. Spiders! Ooh, oh, walked into the corner. We'd really like a deal with the devil, honestly. Get a pentagram, or even guppy items at this point. We have dead cats, all we need is Guppy's collar, Guppy's head, Guppy's paw, any of those and we're set. Headless torsos? I suppose that's a way to describe them. Headless bodies? I don't know what they're called. The heart. Would really, really like to get into that item room. Ooh, do not like that burning. Hey! Ooh, blow these mushrooms up. Two more explosive diarrhea. Wow, three explosive diarrhea pills. Well, hey, it worked. Also, the bombs have the tears effect to them. I'll keep Liberty Cap. So now, explosive diarrhea is actually really good because we can just run around the room, place the load down, and we get tears everywhere. And the tears seem to deal a substantial amount of damage based on the size of them anyway. So let's head down to the next floor. I'm going to take a drink in the meantime. Keep my vocal cords lubricated. Otherwise they'll get they'll get raw very quickly, which they already are doing. Boss trap room. Never going into one of those ever again. They are not worth it. They simply aren't. And before they had an item in them, but now they have nothing. Or they can have anything, I suppose. And especially after the first couple of floors, you're fighting the Chub, which isn't so bad. But then you got Peep, and Peep is not a good one to fight. He's very tough. Very durable. Especially if he's Blurt and not Peep. Now then, curse room. We want to go into there, but not right now because I fear for my life. Keeping out for tinted rocks. Oh, don't like this room. This is scary. This is going to take a while to kill as well. No thanks to the shoddy amount of damage we do, which is absolutely none. Oh, I cannot be trusted to walk around these rooms or not get hit by anything. My god, two hearts of damage on one room. I don't feel good now. I'm pretty sure I'm going to die because I just can't handle these rooms. What floor are we on? Catacombs. That's the harder version, which would explain it. Oh, half a spirit heart. Well, half a heart, not a spirit heart. At this point, I will take whatever I can get. In fact, I'm tempted to open this, and I will. Oh, thank god that paid out. Heck, we can actually go to the shop now. We even got our key back. We did lose the damage, unfortunately. In fact, an item I really want to get now is Cookie's Paw, because I would burn all my health to get it. Paralysis. There's nothing for us. Okay, easy does it. Do not like these guys. Not one bit. It's going to take a while to get through them. I kind of hope there's a demon judgment in that arcade. Oh my god. So much bad damage. I can't deal with these guys. I just can't do it. We don't have the damage. Come on, kill him, please, dead bird. Thank you. In here we have... not what I want. 69 cents. Perfect. This is a bit scary. Thankfully, none of these enemies will kill us in one hit, but it is still scary. A lot of potential damage. Another penny. Would really like, I don't know, a ladder? Yeah, that's how desperate I am. I want the ladder. It's greed, obviously. Why wouldn't it be greed? Which means we're going to have to rely on the secret room for something. In this case, I don't know, raw liver? Just thinking of items from the secret room. Skeleton key would be quite nice, but then again, we don't really have much to use it with, so sort of limiting in that respect. What else would we want? Transcendence. Or the noose, depending on what you want to call it. It is technically a noose. We'll blow up some of these mushrooms. Perfect, you are unknown. Tears up. There we go. Starting to get somewhere now. Oh, scary, 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 scary. Take him out of range. They don't have great range. Just die, please. This is terrifying. I'm going to use bombs because I need to clear out this room. And I do not have enough space to maneuver. Don't die to this room. Please, good God, don't throw. Come on. Easy does it. I would love to use dead bird, but dead bird's usefulness is very limited. Go on, dead bird. Get in there. Okay, easy does. Watch the sides. Okie dokie. Just two left. There we go. Watch the spikes. Bombs and a penny. What are you? Please be something great, because I need something at this point. You are bouncing tears, rubber cement. Oh, that's cool. I know we got this item, but this is actually really cool. Imagine that with brimstone. Ooh, that'd be amazing. I feel like I might die here. Oh, yeah, nothing I can do. Oh, we have 9 lives, so we're not quite out of it yet. Oof. But we did lose all our tears, unfortunately. Or all our health. So now we're just stuck on one. Which is not ideal. But it means now we have a very slim chance. And it's Carrion Queen. There we go, explosive diarrhea. Do your thing. Ooh! And a health upgrade. Again, not what I need at this point. Nothing left to do. We could go to Kershun, but I don't want to. We're just going to have to just slog this through at this point. What are we on? In terms of time. Also, it is I need to do the seed for this run. So it's at 17 minutes. That's for me to remember. And I just dropped my timer. I may have turned it off. I did indeed. That sucks. Not that it matters. But the seed is SBQZ V7LY. So that's good to remember. Okay, Masks of Infamy. This is, yeah. Not much we can do in this room. That's literally all I could do. Come on, Mask. Oh, thank God that happened. Die, heart. Please die. Well, I'd say we got that well. We got lucky. Like, very lucky. I do not want to be in this room. It had to be in Acropolis as well. I should point that out. We're on Necropolis. Not like, what is it? Not catacombs. It's, well, we're on the harder one of the two. We'll put it that way. Okay. Dodgy, dodgy. Walk over creep. That's always a good way to die. Still got 8 lives left, but I really need to stop wasting them. Because we need to keep them. Because we don't have any more. Speed up. I'm actually happy about that. Any of these tinted rocks? Doesn't look like it. We don't need that battery, but I suppose we can take it. There better not be something worthwhile in here now. Midas touched. Not what we need. It may help us, but we need health. And that's the one thing we don't have. Ooh! Brimstoners. I would settle for brimstone at this point. If we can get brimstone, I will be very happy. Oh, spirit heart, thank you. Looks like our damage isn't that bad if we have Horror of Babylon active. But that requires us having Horror of Babylon active. We're going to go there, but we're going to wait for the spikes to clear again. Oh, we don't have any keys. I thought we had one. I'm going to save the bomb. We need it. It's too valuable. And shoot the one at the far end of the room, which we can't hit because we need range. Oh, okay. And that's a tinted rock. You didn't think I wouldn't see you, did you? Hey, spirit heart and a bomb. Starting to get somewhere now. Really having to be careful. But we're getting somewhere. I don't know what that item is, but I'm going to buy it just for the sake of buying it. Extra cards. Should have known. And it's Temperance. Why do you taunt me so? And it is upgrade. We'll put some money into this thing. I doubt we'll have any use for it, so put it all in. 77. And get back across. We are very quick. We also have Liberty Cap, so on some runs we're actually getting Fat Odd Mushroom. Okay, walk around the room, dodge the hand, which is going to be coming down. Here it comes. Easily done. We'll take that because we can. And it doesn't also ruin our effect. Should have known that was Brimstone and not dodged into it. At this point, I wouldn't mind Champion's Belt. Honestly, Champion's Belt would be quite nice. It's a damage upgrade. And it does kind of hurt us in the fact that we'll be fighting tougher enemies. But we're already on the toughest floors. I mean, it can't get much worse. And that's just asking for trouble, I know. Oh, the boss at last. Does that kill other enemies? Oh, never mind. Can't do that. The adversary. First time we're fighting him. This is a little scary. Okie dokie, Midas touch working there. Goddamn spider. I hope this isn't too dark for YouTube. I can see. I don't know about you though. Okay, adversary. He's not too bad. I'm first time fighting him, so I don't know his moves. He's got a curving brimstone by the looks of things. And coughs up spiders. And he's dead. Oh, spider. Aww. And we get tears upgrade plus shot speed up. That's like all we've been getting, tears and shot speed. Well, this is down to the next floor. We're on 18 minutes. We could technically do boss rush. If we can get to the boss room in 2 minutes. And beat Mum in that time as well. Can't go to there, unfortunately. Man, look at our tears. They're not great, but they're killing these guys pretty quickly. Which I suppose is a positive. Come on, there we go. This is 2 Hanged Man cards. Well, we get flying for 2 rooms. Ooh, homing tier 1. Oh, he's tough. It wasn't even us that killed him, it was Dry Baby. Ah, that doesn't fill me with confidence. Neither does that guy, but a spider killed him. I'm gonna use Hangman here. Hey, this works. Also, he can dodge very easily out of the way. Any of those tinted rocks, he says while not paying attention. Thank you, Dry Baby. None of these look like tinted rocks, I don't see any X's, so keep on moving along. Okay. Do not get hit by the brimstones, that would be a bad thing. He says he stands in the range of one. We could actually die on this room very easily. Oh boy. God damn you, dead cat. Well, that worked, but that's our last bomb. So now we are making do with whatever we can get hold of, which is not a lot. So far, 9 lives has certainly saved me. But it's also dragging this out. I don't mind that much. I mean, I do like to at least put out a decent length of video. At least we showed the scrimped and tried our hardest to be able to pull a victory out. I mean, there's not much we can do without any damage upgrades. Tears are fine, but they get capped out eventually, so we don't exactly have a lot. We need to go to the item room. We just need to. And just pray there's a damage upgrade in there. Max's head. Steven. I don't know. I'm trying to name damage upgrades. Cat and Nine Tails. That's a damage upgrade. And I would take it. Oh, Double Dingle. Well, not the truly horrific version of Dingle. And by that I mean the actual version. but I don't like this. Also, we're very quick. Okie dokie. There we go. Don't think we're going to die in this room with any luck. It's not the hardest room in the world. The enemies are pretty weak, and we can kill them pretty quickly thanks to our tears. But this is not the way I want to go, because this doesn't lead to the item room. Let's try for the secret room at least. Well, we can't try there. What about the other side? Technically, we could if we used a hangman. But that's kind of a waste of a hangman card. And we don't have any bombs either, so that's that idea down the drain. I'm going to take a drink in the meantime. Oh. Note to self, don't take a drink when you're in the middle of a dangerous room. Especially not full of enemies that are very dangerous and can kill you in one hit. I'm liking rubber cement though, I will say that. This is annoying, but not unbeatable. And that's a boss trap room, which I'll stick my head into. Nope! Not doing that unless desperate times happen. Well, we can see the item room now thanks to Liberty Cap, giving us a compass effect. Ugh. Rubber cement actually sometimes clips through them slightly, so we can actually hit them. Another key. Might do the boss trap room now. Ooh. Might. Ooh, tough love. This actually might help tremendously. I can't bring myself to do the boss trap room. It's just not worth it. Too risky. So it's off to the mum fight with 1 HP and bad damage. This is either going to be us dying 6 more times, or the most amazing victory I've ever pulled out. And then obviously we're going down to the next floor. Let's stick to the shop and see what we have. Super greed. Couldn't have asked for anything else. Wow, bouncing your teeth actually is really good. I never took that into account. So, let's head to the boss fight and pray. Probably we'll use the hangman card as well so we can actually get around the room. Hangman. There's Mum's foot. Use the tears. Ooh, don't stand in the way of Mum's foot. Really, really like some bombs. Some bombs would just make this so much nicer. Ooh, dry baby. Oh, what? Oh, I walked into it. No, we don't have hangman. Now we don't have hanged men anymore. That sucks. Wow, enemy spawning hurts. Gotta be more careful of that. Ooh. Wow, Midas touch. Does that stop the foot? It might actually stop the foot completely. I'm tempted to try it now. However foolish it is. Well. Oh my god, we did it. Through the most weird and cheesiest way possible. Is this placenta? It is. It's a HP upgrade, which is not exactly ideal, but wow, we are scrounging to say the least. But I'm liking the run. At least we've got a mum kill. So 23 minutes, so about 25 for the video length. Sucks. We can't keep relying on dried baby at this point. We need damage. We've got tough love, which is decent. Not great. And tough love's, I think, just like 200% more damage. I don't know. I pulled that number off the top of my head. But I hope it's something like that. It seems to be. So, really need damage. In fact, we haven't had a single damage upgrade this entire run. So, to say we're at Eve base damage of 1, we're pretty good. We're doing okay. He says he gets hit for 1 full heart damage and dies. I don't think I can do that room. Too much horror in it. I don't think that bomb counted. It did. Okay. Ooh, the dodgers. Oh my god. Okay. I would love to play you, Demon Judgment, but I can't. So I'm going to put a bomb here and play normal judgment. What does he have for us? Just give us something, man. And not like ladder or something. I don't need that at this point. The map. Well, it's good. We actually have a mini boss. Let's head this way. This looks kind of promising. It is a terminal, so it could contain the boss at the end of it. Another penny. Don't know why I went this way. There's a heart, but we can't do anything with it. Yep, this contains the boss. Let's get rid of you before you break free. So what's our boss? That is the question. Teratoma. We couldn't ask for better. Now all I've got to do is make sure I don't get hit. Which is easier said than done. 2 lives left. I'm going to place down 2 bombs and just pray. Oh, god damn it. I don't know if I can actually beat Teratoma. I just suck at dodging and I don't have the HP required to dodge the spiders. Especially not when they fly out of the Teratoma pieces. So let's take this a bit slower. And not just try going a Hail Mary. Okie dokie. Easily does it. Oh my god, an angel room. And a matchbook. Gives us bombs, which our bombs are actually like our main source of damage. What do we have? Oh, my nun's habit. Don't need nun's habit. Oh, thank you for nothing. Sit down. At least we have at least 3 HP, so we can take 3 hits and not die. Head up immediately. I'm going to go to that room. It might have a dice in it, and I would take a dice at this point. It's like number 5, I think, is the one we want. Because I think 5 rerolls all your stats and items. Which might not be great, but it's a better chance. It's just better than nothing. 3 golden chests. Yes, yes, and yes. Well, got a lot of other items which I don't really need. Come on, something. What's in here? Ah, so tempting. Screw it. I had to. No choice. We need something. And those cards might actually provide us with what we need if they're jokers. Actually, jokers would just take us down to the next floor. So that wouldn't be so good, actually. Oh, Loki. Loki's not so bad. Don't walk into his shots. What is this? 2 of diamonds. Use that straight away. That is the Hierophant. I'm going to use that as well. Because, you know. Job. 3 semi-easy bosses. Not so hard. Magician and Joker. Let's use Joker and see what happens. Just down to the next floor. Which is not something we can do. I mean, we could head to Shoal and die on Shoal, but we do need to try and beat the boss. This room scares me. Thank God for bouncing tears. Or rubber cement. Any tinted rocks in here? Don't see any. Gurglings! Yay. Wouldn't be a room without gurglings. Not too bad, I suppose. Our tears aren't terrible with Horror Babylon. I need Guppy's Paw, I think, at this rate. Or Bum, Dark Bum. We need a game-winning item. It's as simple as that. And we don't have it. We might as well. I mean, we need to get through this room. And removing all possible damage is a good idea. Oh, I don't know if I want to try for a secret room. It could be just too stupid. I mean, our bombs are so good, we need them. Because we've got nothing else. Key and a penny. Oh, we can see the boss, so the boss is definitely up here. which is good to know. Good information to have. Let's get in Mum's heart. We have no orbitals. What else? Walking over creep, always a smart idea, so we now have one less HP than we did previously. And what else? Not much. We will check for secret rooms, because that's like our only out at this point. If anything, I really don't want it to be raw liver. I want just something else. And there has to be something, some way of pulling this out. I don't even know if it will work. Let's go down to this other area. I mean, we're pretty much dead at this point. There's no doubt about it, but it's all about how much of a fight we put up at this point. There it is. Key beggar. Yes. Take my keys. Give me something. I have no use of them. Oh, nice. A draw bomb. Couldn't have asked for better. Flies. They'll help very briefly. Come on. Got another key. Let's play him again. And blow him up. And he gives us High Priestess. That sort of helps, ish. And the Chariot. How do we cycle between cards? Oh, that's mute. Well, I don't know, and I don't care. We're taking the Chariot, and we're going to use it. And probably still die. I'd like the Empress, but I don't know how to cycle cards. So, joke's on me, I suppose. Well, in we go. Spiders, flies, not a hell of a lot else. We've got a very slim chance, to say the least. After all, it's not over till the fat lady sings, as they say. Gonna need to drop bombs because we have nothing else. That activated, okay. Chariot. Oh my god, we did it. Oh my god, we did it. Down to shoal? No, I'm just going to end this here. We've won, and I'm taking this victory and leaving with it. Oh dear. So everything is terrible. The game just got harder. And we won. I'm taking that victory. We didn't go down to shoal, but we scrounged our life off for that. And we did it. So Horror of Babylon definitely saved us there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. It was a bit exhausting, to say the least. If you have, leave a like, subscribe to see more, and I'll see you all next time.